God, we just come to you tonight, quiet our thoughts. We make space for you to speak. We make space for you to meet us here. Choose to fix our eyes on you. Choose to fix our eyes on Him, in which there is no darkness at all. The one who's able to cast out every fear with His perfect love. Tonight be a night where people who have been forgiven much are able to love much, where we're able to break our alabaster jars at your feet before the one who is worthy, and be an overflow of thanksgiving and praise. May the fragrance of our worship be pleasing to you.
That one
seek a crown for my reward is giving glory to you. 'Cause I wanna take your word and shine it all around. First help me just tell me just to live it, Lord. And when I'm doing well, help me to never seek a crown, for my reward is giving glory to you. Oh, glory to you.
Deserve
deserve the highest praise. You deserve the highest praise, Jesus. You deserve the highest praise. You deserve the highest praise. You deserve the highest praise, Jesus. Jesus. Oh.
Jesus, my glory, my soul. Jesus.
Jesus. You be a vision. You be a vision. You say, without vision, your people perish. And you say, without vision, your people go astray. You say, without vision, your people perish. So give us a vision of you. Give us a vision of you. Give us a vision. Give us a vision of you. Thank you. Show me your glory, O God. Show me your glory. Show me your glory. For I long to look on the face of the one that I love, long to stay in your presence. It's where I belong, long to look on the face of the one that I love, long to stay in your presence. It's where I belong, I long to look on the face of the one that I love, long to stay in your presence. It's where I belong, long to look on the face of the one that I love, long to stay in your presence. It's where I belong. So show me your glory. Show me your glory. Show me your glory.
This is where I belong. You carried me all this time.
as rock, I'll sing your praise. Hallelujah. Forever now in the greatness of my Savior. Forever now in the brightness of your name. Jesus, on this rock, I'll sing.
Our vision. Sometimes what we can see, the things that we see can be so powerful, whether it's something just gruesome or something that's so beautiful. It stays in our mind. The image of it stays in our mind for such a long time. And God, just show us the image of you. Let the image of you just be burned into our eyes, Father. The image of how beautiful you are. The image of the Father who gave his Son for us. The image of you, Jesus, dying on that cross. Let that vision be in our minds constantly. We don't want you to be just an afterthought. We don't want to just think of you, you know, whenever we eat food or before we go to sleep. We want to think of you constantly, God. We don't want you to be in the back of our minds. We want you to be at the forefront, God. So God, let our gaze be upon you tonight and forevermore. In Jesus' name, amen. We will now be going into a time of worshiping in the Word. We encourage you to open your Bibles to tonight's passage, Hosea 14, verses 1 to 9. As we read through, we invite you to meditate on the Word, pray, and allow the Holy Spirit to speak to you through the passage. Once again, the passage is Hosea 14, verses 1 to 9. We will start with verses 1 to 3. Return, Israel, to the Lord your God. Your sins have been your downfall. Take words with you and return to the Lord. Say to him, forgive all our sins and receive us graciously, that we may offer the fruit of our lips. Assyria cannot save us. We will not mount war horses. We will never again say, our gods to what our own hands have made. For anew the fatherless find compassion. Father, you are calling for Israel to return to you, not with a tone of anger, but like the tone of just a father calling out desperately for his child to return to him. And time again, not just Israel throughout history, but mankind in general as well, has fallen short of your glory. We often forget that our sins just only cause our downfall, that it only leads to death. So Father, just open our eyes to look to you, the you which restores and prolongs us instead of sin which leads to our decay. God, you also call Israel to take their words with them and return to you. You don't want us to be like those who come near to you with their mouth and honor you with their lips, yet their hearts are far from you. You don't want us to flatter you. You don't want us to give you lip service with empty words, saying things because we should. No, you want genuine love. You want our words to you to just be genuine and sincere out of the burning hearts for you, God. God, we could speak in tongues of men, tongues of angels, but if we don't have love, it's just a resounding gong. It's just a clanging cymbal to you. So when we ask for forgiveness, or when we ask you to receive us graciously, let it be out of the desire of our hearts, just out of a hunger for you, out of a longing to return to you, God. Let it not be empty words. And let Israel, let also us not have to rely on rulers or authorities or any powers, not relying or not running to man, not relying on idols made with our own hands. Even the dreams that we have, the goals, the pet projects we have that we've spent so much time on, that we spent so many resources on. No, that's not important compared to you, God. It's trash compared to you. You are more important, Father. We rely on you. You are a God also of grace and compassion, Father. That means you have just a feeling of deep sympathy and sorrow for us when we're stricken by misfortune. You feel sorrow for us when you see us in our sin. So God, help us understand the sorrow, the grief, just how much we break your heart when we just disobey you. We pray that Israel realizes that as well, and that they will want to turn to you. They will want to not break your heart anymore because of their love for you, Father.
We've made and called it a God, Lord.
6. I will heal their waywardness and love them freely, for my anger has turned away from them. I will be like the dew to Israel. He will blossom like a lily. Like a cedar of Lebanon, he will send down his roots. His young shoots will grow. His splendor will be like an olive tree, his fragrance like a cedar of Lebanon. People will dwell again in his shade. They will flourish like the grain. They will blossom like the vine. Israel's fame will be like the wine of Lebanon. Father, no matter how far we've fallen off the path, you've always been willing to offer your hand of restoration and your hand of free love. You redeemed us out of the pit. And Israel, throughout history, like us, has become like Gomer, running away from you over and over again in disobedience. Yet you still chose to pursue Israel like Hosea and love the nation freely when you didn't have to. You chose Israel, God, and in the same way, you chose us. After all our disobedience, you could have said enough, and you could have unleashed your wrath and anger upon us, but you turned your anger away. Just like you call us to turn away from our idols, you call us to turn away and repent from our idols and sin, God, to you. God, you turned away from your anger. You chose to instead love and heal your people. And Father, you promise that Israel will flourish like a tree, that it will be strong and fragrant like a cedar, have the beauty of a lily. And we pray that that cedar that Israel will become will be firmly rooted and established, that will not be shaken. Let not only Israel believe in this promise, but us as well, us that is interceding on behalf for this nation. Let us pray that Israel, their delight will be in the law of the Lord, and that they will meditate on it day and night, that they will be like a tree planted by streams of water that yields its fruit in its season, and its leaf does not wither. In all that they do, that they will prosper. Let Israel be a tree with roots down deep, unwavering until Jesus, you return. We pray that Israel will claim this promise that you have made, that it will flourish and it will blossom and be a blessing to the nations. And we help, and just help us realize that us interceding for this nation will in turn bless us as well. And God, as Israel is fruitful, as you reveal your love and grace that transforms us, God, let us, let Israel offer our worship, our thanksgiving upon you for what you've done for us.
To
brought healing into us. You brought healing. You brought healing. Shadow. dwell beneath your shade. You will take us and make us new, flourishing out to show your fruit for your glory. All is for your glory. All is for your praise. All is for your glory. All is for your praise. All is for your glory. All is for your praise.
It's not for anyone else.
All is for. All is for your praise. All is for your glory.
We give it all to you.
All is for your praise. All is for your glory. And all is for.
Hosea 14, verses 8 to 9. Ephraim, what more have I to do with idols? I will answer him and care for him. I am like a flourishing juniper. Your fruitfulness comes from me. Who is wise? Let them realize these things. Who is discerning? Let them understand. The ways of the Lord are right. The righteous walk in them, but the rebellious stumble in them. Father, you no longer want idols in our lives. You don't want them to have any part in us, God, in our walk with you. And you're asking us, you ask Israel why they're running to idols, why they're running to man, when you are the one who answers and cares for us. God, it's you whose ears are attentive to our cry. You say you are like a flourishing juniper, and just as Jesus, you said you are the vine and we are the branches. You are a source that if we remain in you and you in us, we will bear much fruit, that apart from you, we can do nothing. And let Israel and let us remain in you and become fruitful, Father. Fruit that will bless others and build your kingdom. And God, we pray that you will help us not forget the true aspect, the righteousness of your ways, God. That as the heavens are higher than the earth, so your ways are higher than ours. And give Israel the discernment and the wisdom you graciously give to all without fault, to walk in your path with righteousness, God. That the cry of both Israel's and our hearts will be, I run in the path of your commands, for you have broadened my understanding and you have enlarged my heart. God, help us realize that rebellion and disobedience will only cause us to stumble. And we thank you, God, that just for your patience and for the grace you display to us despite our constant failure to realize that your presence is so much greater than anything in this world that we can run to, God. And it's mind-blowing that despite Israel running away from you over and over, that they kept sacrificing to the Baals and burning offering to idols, and yet still you said, how can I give you up, O Ephraim? How can I hand you over, O Israel? My heart recoils within me. My compassion grows warm and tender. Father, let us not forget that, God, You're not just a fearful king and almighty, powerful creator of the earth that rules the heavens and the earth. You're also a father. You're a father. You are a good, good father who loves us so much and who loves Israel very much, God. And we just pray that, God, you will help us and you will help Israel gain greater revelation of the father that you are. The father whose love is so wasteful, God, who is always waiting for us no matter how far we run away and is always willing to welcome us.
Disarm us of our idols. Oh God, how you disarm us of our idols. You strip them away. You strip them away from our hearts.
You grow us in wisdom.
Seal of fire.
You mark us.
burns for you.
You mark us for your glory, Jesus. Oh, you mark us for your glory. You mark us for to the one who gave it all for us. May we not hold back. May we not hold back. To the one who gave it all for us. May we not hold back. May we not hold back. Now to the one gave it all for us. May we not hold back. May we not hold back. Now to the one who gave it all for us. May we not hold back. May we not hold back. Don't give your heart in pieces. troubled mind. It isn't anxious, it's not the restless kind. Your love's not passive, it's never disengaged, it's always present, it hangs on every word you say. Love keeps its promises. Its vows are good. Your love's not broken, it's not insecure. Your love's not selfish, your love is pure. You don't give your heart in
gave us your everything. You poured it all out for us. You didn't give it in pieces. You gave us everything when we gave you nothing. You gave us your son. You sacrificed your only son for us when we didn't deserve it, when you didn't owe us anything. And it's because of this and so much more that we need to give our all for you, Father. We need to give our all for you. Yeah, Father. Now, we also pray that that is also the cry of Israel's heart, to give their all for you as well. Now go into a time of prayer and intercession on behalf of the nation of Israel. As I pray, we ask that you come into agreement and then follow with your own intercession. Father, we pray that you will restore the nation of Israel, no matter how far they are away from you, that you will transform and restore their lives to righteous ones. God, rather than providing your wrath, you are providing your healing for these people. And Father, you have redeemed us out of the darkest, out of the deepest of pits. You have the power to transform anyone's life. And so, Father, we just declare Paul-like transformations among the nation of Israel. Just sheer transformations, no matter how people, no, even if people may be against you, you will transform their hearts. Even the most bitter of hearts, even the most hard of hearts, you will transform and soften their hearts for you, Father. You will burn their hearts for you. And we pray that, God, you will allow Israel to develop a desire for repentance, to turn to you, Father. That you will give the people the discerning eyes to see the idols that's in their heart. That the further they pursue these, that the further that it will lead to their downfall, God. And that instead that following you, that pursuing you is what gives them life. And so, Father, we pray for a hunger for repentance out of a desire to please you, God. And we declare that many hearts will turn to you. And even if the nation falls, even if the people may fall and stumble and fall short of your glory, that they will get back up immediately and pursue you again even stronger, God. We pray also that you will give them a greater revelation of your love and your grace as you heal this nation, that they will get a greater glimpse of the Father's heart, that they can only credit the transformation of their lives to you, and that the revelation of you will be greater than the revelation of anything else in their lives, and that they will also share this revelation to others as their testimony of how you changed them, God, how you changed their lives, God, how you saved them. And we also prophesy that as you soften their hearts, that they will understand the great love you have for them since the beginning for this nation. That same love that since the nation was a child who you taught to walk, who you took them up by your arms, that this nation will know that you are the one who healed them, that you are the one who led them with cords of kindness, with the bands of love, that the same love, it led to you to send your son. It led to the greatest act of love, God. And that we pray that they will discover this sacrifice, Jesus, that you made on the cross. We prophesy that they will know and believe in the greatest act of love in history. Let's pray. we pray for this nation. We pray for the healing over all diseases and injuries over these people. We pray that, knowing that diseases and pain is not from you, God, and that you instead desire the people you love to walk out in freedom from any pain, from any sickness, God. You don't want to see your children hindered, Father. And we pray that we ask that all infirmities in Israel, in the people of Israel, will be healed in the name of Jesus. And we just pray that any diseases, that they will be healed, and that we will ask that these even include incurable diseases, diseases where there's no known cure, that it will astonish even doctors. It will astonish many, God. Mankind will call it a death sentence, but Father, we follow the one, Jesus, who overcame death itself. And so, Father, we believe that you will heal. We believe that you are Jehovah Rapha, Father. We pray for hope of healing over those with these kinds of incurable diseases. We pray against any despair. We pray instead for a belief in your healing power, Lord God. And we pray that testimonies of healing will break out in this nation and will not only bring hope to others, but point the people to you, God, as their healer, that they will point to you, Jehovah Rapha, as their healer, that no one else can heal like you do, God. And we pray that, Father, you will provide spiritual gifts of healing upon the people of Israel that will just break out in the nation. Gifts that will help build your kingdom. And as they heal others, that many will choose, that many will believe in you, that many will just open their eyes to who you are, Jesus, as their source, as their life, as their healer, and ultimately as the truth. Let's pray.
Thank you.
we just pray for restoration in relationships within the nation. We pray that we just ask that you'll break any bitterness and any unforgiveness that may be inherent in the people. We ask that the nation will be one that doesn't hold grudges, that a nation that won't be characterized by unforgiveness, but be a nation that is known as one that forgives and one that loves, God. And we pray that Israel knows to immediately forgive because they've been forgiven themselves. And we pray for a culture of forgiveness and love will be established in this nation, and that Israel will be a praiseworthy example for other societies to emulate. We also pray that you'll restore even the most broken of marriages, even marriages that are in danger of divorce, God. God, you do not desire divorce. Divorce breaks your heart, Father. And that no matter the conflict, that couples will just love each other as Jesus, you love the church. We also pray that the most broken of families will also be restored. We pray the Father's love over parents to their children, and also the other way, and a desire in the children to honor their parents, Father. And we pray whatever tension, whatever conflict may be in the families, we just pray that you will alleviate it. You will lift it off. Let there be no burdens in the families, God. Let there be no conflicts. Let there be love for each other. And we just pray that as Israel establishes this culture of forgiveness, we pray that they will be able to take initiative to offer their hand of peace and compromise to other nations. We pray that other nations will be impacted by this gesture, and that they will be more than willing to amicably work with Israel. We pray any bitterness or frustration in other nations towards Israel will be lifted up. Any hate harbored towards them, towards the nation, will be broken down in the name of Jesus. And any anti-Israeli agendas or schemes that have been made in other nations, that they will be brought down in the name of Jesus, and that there will be instead honor, there will be respect, there will be just, there will be a revering of this nation that you love, Father, that they will be more than willing to support and intercede for this nation. Yeah, God, you love this nation so much. It is this nation that you have chosen to love freely. It is this nation that you have loved since the beginning, since they were a child. It is a nation you raised up. It is a nation you delivered out of Egypt. It's a nation that even though they ran away from you over and over again, that you still offer to heal them of their waywardness. You still choose to love them. Israel is a nation that is loved by you, and that we must intercede for this nation continually. Let us never cease to intercede and pray for this nation, God, that you love so much. We pray that Israel will also come to realize this love you have for them, God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. We hope that you are blessed in God's presence. Praying for Israel sometimes.